लास्ट लेक्चरला आपण काय काय घेतलं? सुप्रिया, आवाज येतोय सगळ्यांना? सांगा बघ. संपदा, सोनाली मडके, यस, येस संपदा.
सर ऑप्शनच येत नाही चॅट साठी.
मग बोलू शकते आता?
लास्ट लेक्चरला जॉईन नाही झालं आमचं,
जॉईन नाही झालं? का नाही झालं?
नेटवर्कच काहीतरी प्रॉब्लेम आहे आयडियाचा, त्यामुळे बऱ्याच वेळा होतच नाही.
ब्लॅक बॉक्स टेस्टिंग आणि व्हाईट बॉक्स टेस्टिंग.
ब्लॅक बॉक्स टेस्टिंग अँड व्हाईट बॉक्स टेस्टिंग. गुड. सो वी हॅव सीन डिफरंट टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग. सो फर्स्ट दॅट सॉफ्टवेअर टेस्टिंग डेफिनेशन वी हॅव सीन. सो हाऊ टू डू टेस्टिंग. सो विच आर द पीपल्स आर इन्वॉल्व विथ दॅट टेस्टिंग. देन वी हॅव सीन मेजर टू टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्टिंग. फर्स्ट इज द मॅन्युअल टेस्टिंग अँड सेकंड इज ऑटोमेशन टेस्टिंग, टेस्ट ऑटोमेशन. सो व्हॉट इज मॅन्युअल टेस्टिंग? मॅन्युअली यू ओपन दॅट ॲप्लिकेशन अँड यू टेस्ट दॅट. सो लाईक लॉग इन फॉर्म, यू चेक दॅट युजर नेम अँड पासवर्ड वेन यू एंटर करेक्ट, यू आर गेटिंग लॉग इन पेज ऑर नॉट इनबॉक्स. वेन यू टाईप इन करेक्ट, यू आर गेटिंग एरर मेसेज ऑर नॉट. सो लाईक दिस मॅन्युअली यू आर डुईंग टेस्टिंग. So for manual testing, you have to take a lot of efforts, a lot of time is required to do manual testing. But in automation testing, you are using some tools for automation like Selenium. In that you write a small code in Java or Python or .NET. So Selenium is compatible with a lot of languages. So you can write that code and you can do testing. So in today's lecture, we will see what is that tool in detail. So I am going to share the PPT. So you can tell that presentation is visible or not. So is it visible? My screen is visible to all?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
So it take a few seconds to refresh and that screen will be visible to you. Now it is visible. ज्यांना दिसत नव्हती त्यांना दिसते का आता?
नो
नो. So now ज्यांचा माईक अनम्यूट आहे त्यांनी म्यूट करा, फक्त बोलतानाच फक्त अनम्यूट करून बोला. संपदा, नाउ प्रेजेंटेशन इज विजिबल टू ऑल. यस, प्रेजेंटेशन दिसते का सगळ्यांना? सांगा.
नाही दिसत सर.
यस सर, दिसते ना.
ज्यांना दिसत नसेल त्यांचा नेटवर्कचा इश्यू असेल. So most of the students, yes, so it takes a few seconds to refresh. So actually we have started the syllabus, the examination scheme already you know. So like third year you are having 30 marks in semester exam and end semester of 70 marks. So in semester on first 3 units and end semester on all 6 units. So in today's lecture we will see actual what is Selenium tool, that part in unit 4th, but that part is very important. So when you have to do career as a tester you have to learn this tool. So that's why I have taken this topic early. So in this lecture we will see introduction to Selenium, then what are the Selenium tools, which are the components are associated with Selenium, then what are the advantages of using Selenium, then what are the disadvantages, so that we will see in this lecture. So see, what is Selenium? Selenium, it is a open source tool which are portable for automation testing. So using that you can test web applications. It is compatible with the different browser and operating systems. So like Java, you know, you can do Java programming in a different operating system. Java is a platform independent. So like this way Selenium you can use on different operating system and it support different browsers like Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome. On that you can use Selenium open source tool. Then using this Selenium, Selenium is not just a tool, it is a set of tools that helps the testers to automate web applications. So this is Selenium. It is open source, it is portable. You can do testing with different operating system, different web browsers. And this is not a single tool, it is a set of tool. What is the use? To test the web application. And it helps in automation. No need to manually test. No need to open each web page and test the code. Selenium will does the job of testers. Next, which are the tools are associated with Selenium? So first and most important tool is the Selenium IDE. So what is IDE? IDE is the Integrated Development Environment. What is Selenium IDE? It is Firefox plugin that is used by the tester to record the actions which happens when test is automated. काय सेलेनियम आयडी? किती फायरफॉक्सची प्लगिन आहे. जेव्हा तुम्ही टेस्टिंग करता तर सेलेनियम कसं टेस्ट करतं तर ते सगळं त्याचा एक व्हिडिओ रेकॉर्ड करतो त्याचा. सो जेव्हा टेस्टिंग होईल तेव्हा ते टेस्टर्स चेक करू शकतात की त्या वेब ॲप्लिकेशनने कसं बिहेव केलं, कोणत्या टेस्ट पास झाल्या, कोणत्या फेल झाल्या. So this is Selenium IDE. Then next, Selenium RC. This is the second tool in Selenium. So what is Selenium RC? RC stand for remote control. Then what is the job of Selenium RC? That Selenium RC is the testing framework. Then what is the job? It allows to capture simple browser's action in linear manner. Ja browser cha actions ahet tya te Selenium RC capture karta. Then this you can use with a different programming languages. So list is given. So you can use the Selenium RC with Java, C sharp, PHP, Python, Ruby, Perl. So like that, different languages are supported by this tool. So getting all of you, Selenium RC, it is a Selenium remote control. It is a framework to capture browser action, and different languages are supported with this framework. Next, Selenium WebDriver. So what is Selenium WebDriver? It is the next version of Selenium remote control. Selenium RC's next successor is the Selenium WebDriver. And what is the job? These Selenium WebDrivers send commands to the browsers and retrieve the results. काय करतो सेलेनियम वेब ड्रायव्हर? ब्राउझरला कमांड सेंड करतो आणि त्याच्यापासून जे रिझल्टचे आउटपुट येईल ते कॅप्चर करतो. दॅट इज द जॉब ऑफ सेलेनियम वेब ड्रायव्हर. दिस इज द थर्ड मोस्ट टूल ऑफ सेलेनियम. सो वी हॅव सीन थ्री टूल्स. विच आर दोज? फर्स्ट इज द सेलेनियम आयडीई, सेकंड इज द सेलेनियम रिमोट कंट्रोल सेलेनियम आरसी, third Selenium WebDriver. Then next tool is the Selenium Grid. So what is the job of this tool? This tool is used to run parallel tests across different machines and browsers simultaneously with minimum time. Getting all of you? So using Selenium grid, you achieve parallelism. Tumhala at a time more than one test execute karayche, then you can use Selenium grid, and using this on different machines on different browsers simultaneously you execute multiple test cases and with minimum execution time. So this is the job of Selenium grid. Then in this slide there is a difference between Selenium tool and QTP. QTP is also a automation tool. So we see the difference. What is the first difference? Can anyone read? Yes. Bharat, Priyanka, can you read what is the first difference? Dangat, Pooja,
Selenium is an open source tool.
Yes, and in QTP? What is written in QTP?
People host one of the license.
Yes. So are you getting what is the first difference? Why Selenium is popular? Because it is open source tool. So when you use Selenium for testing, you can download freely from internet and you can use. But QTP is the commercial tool. You have to pay for this automation tool. Then and then only you get the license and then you can use for testing. Then second, what is the second difference? Vrushali Mande. What is the second difference? Are you able to see? Unmute yourself and tell. Borude Sneha.
Can be extended for various technologies that expose DOM limit in QTP, limited add-ons and needs add-ons for each one of the technologies.
Good. So in Selenium, we use DOM model. So DOM model we have seen in web technology. Have you remember? Document object model. So using that, we understand whole structure of web application using Selenium. But in QTP, there is limitations. You have to use add-ons, plugins to test the web application. And for each technology, you have to use add-on plugins. So that is the limitation. That's why Selenium is popular. Next. What is the third difference? Pratiksha Kale. What is the third difference? Pooja Shirke. Sayed Aisha. प्रांजल साळुंके
has capability to execute script across different browser. OTP can run test is specified various of Firefox, IE and Chrome.
Good. So Selenium supports all the browsers, but QTP having limitation, it supports only three browsers: Mozilla Firefox, IE is Internet Explorer, and Google Chrome. So that is the limitation of QTP. Then next, what is the next difference? Kalyani Gondge. काजल गवळी व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट डिफरन्स सोनाली मडके What is the difference?
Selenium can execute scripts on various operating system. QTP works only with the Windows.
So very simple. Selenium. In Selenium, you can do testing on all operating systems, various operating systems. But QTP having limitation, you can work with QTP on a Windows operating system. You can't test applications on Linux using QTP. Next difference, Sayed Aisha. Unmute yourself and read. Yes. Kalyani. Dangat Puja.
Selenium supports mobile devices and QTP supports mobile devices with the help of third party tools.
Good. So Selenium, it supports mobile devices. You know, mobile devices. In QTP also, it supports mobile devices, but you have to use third party tools for testing. Selenium मध्ये स्वतःचे inbuilt support आहेत mobile device साठी, but here you have to use third party tools. दुसऱ्या कंपनीने यूज केलेले टूल्स आहेत ते तुम्हाला इंटिग्रेट करावे लागतात QTP मध्ये आणि मग तुम्ही यूज करता ते. Next, संपदा खेतमाळस, व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट डिफरन्स?
सर स्क्रीन नाही दिसत आहे मला.
स्क्रीन दिसत नाही?
नाही.
काय दिसतंय मग?
When the meeting starts, we will let people know you are waiting in the lobby.
स्क्रीनशॉट काढून पाठव व्हॉट्सअप ग्रुपला.
ओके.
परत एकदा जॉईन करा, मी रिमूव्ह करतो इथनं.
ओके,
ज्यांना स्क्रीन दिसत नाही त्यांनी सांगा. इथे 13 स्टुडंट्स आहेत, सगळ्यांना दिसतंय का स्क्रीन? बाकीच्यांना दिसतोय का सगळ्यांना स्क्रीन जो डिफरन्स आहे? ओके, म्यूट युअर सेल्फ. सो देर आर लॉट ऑफ पॉइंट्स इन डिफरन्स. Using Selenium, we test only web applications, but using QTP, you can test desktop application as well as web applications. Then in Selenium, there is no feature as object repository, recovery scenario, but QTP having the feature of built-in object repositories and recovery scenarios. So in Selenium there is no IDE, so script development is slow, but in QTP there is intuitive IDE. Using that you are getting hints. That's why that whatever the script you have to write, that script will be written very fast, so automation happens very fast. Getting all of you? Next difference, Selenium madhe IDE nahiye, tyachyamule code tumhala remember karava lagto ani lihava lagto, but QTP madhe IDE ahe. Tumhi I takla ki tyachya related keywords tumhala yetil, tyamule QTP chi script lihna khup sopa jata ani fast hoto. Next, सेलेनियम मध्ये जे कंट्रोल्स आहेत ते तुम्ही ब्राउझर मध्ये ऍक्सेस करू शकत नाहीत. यू कॅनॉट ऍक्सेस कंट्रोल्स विद इन द ब्राउझर्स, बट इन QTP यू कॅन ऍक्सेस कंट्रोल्स विद इन द ब्राउझर्स. सो विच आर द कंट्रोल्स यू कॅन ऍक्सेस इन QTP? फेवरेट बार्स, बॅकवर्ड अँड फॉरवर्ड बटन्स फॉर ऑटोमेशन. सो दिस आर द फीचर्स आर available with the QTP. So this is the difference. So lot of difference we have seen. 10 to 12 points are there, so you have to write at least 6 to 10 points when in exam they will ask the difference. Then next, this is the whole package of Selenium tool suite. So that four we have seen, which are the tools of Selenium. First is the Selenium IDE, that is Selenium Integrated Development Environment, Selenium RC, Selenium Remote Control, Selenium Web Driver, Selenium Grid. So this is the first version. In that there was four components. In second version they have combined Selenium RC and Selenium Web Driver. Then after Selenium 2, there is new improved version Selenium 3. जसं आपण पाहतो कोणतंही ऍप्लिकेशन आलं की त्याचे वेगवेगळे व्हर्जन्स असतात. सो लाईक दॅट सेलेनियम ऑल्सो हॅज नाऊ अपडेटेड व्हर्जन सेलेनियम 3. इनिशियली देर वॉज सेलेनियम 1, Selenium 2, and now new improve Selenium 3. So this is Selenium tool suite. Then what is Selenium IDE? That we will see in detail. So already we have seen what is that. It is a Firefox plugin to develop test cases. and it provides the GUI, graphical user interface, for recording what happens when you do testing. Initially, in Selenium, only Firefox browser was supported and other browser was, there was no support for other browsers. Then what is the job? It records the whatever happen in web browsers. जेव्हा तुम्ही वेब ऍप्लिकेशन टेस्ट करता तर ते टेस्ट करताना काय काय होतं, कसं कसं होतं ते इट विल बी हँडल्ड बाय द सेलेनियम आय डी ई. देन नेक्स्ट, दीज आर द फीचर्स. सो इन सेलेनियम आय डी देर आर डिफरंट कंट्रोल्स. फर्स्ट कंट्रोल फॉर स्पीड कंट्रोल. What is the speed you have to keep for executing the test cases? Second, if you have written multiple test cases, then you have to, if you have to run all, then you can click on this run all. This is the control to execute the entire test suite with multiple test cases. Then there is another third control, run. So it will execute only selected test case. Also there is control of resume or pause option. So you want to pause the test case, and if you want to check what is happening before this testing, or again you have to resume, again you have to restart, then you can click on that controls. Then there is control step. So that arrow is there blue, in blue color. So what is the use of step? If you want to do debugging of that test, then you can click on the step control. Then there is another control, test runner mode. So what is the job of test runner? It allows user to execute test case in a browser loaded with Selenium core. Then apply rollup. So what is the job of apply rollup? If you have to do a repetitive task, then you can do, you can use this control. So getting all of you, these are the controls you are having in Selenium IDE. So which are those? First is the speed control, run all, run, resume and pause, step, then test runner mode, apply rollup. So these are the controls, these are the features of Selenium integrated development environment. Then next, so software quality having two levels. So it is called as product quality matrix. So in that metric, there are different levels. First is the mean time to failure. Second is the defect density. Next is the customer problems. Then customer satisfaction. These are the different metrics which is associated with the software quality. And major two levels are intrinsic product quality, and second is the customer satisfaction. So getting all of you, how we can tell that software is of good quality? So ya levels ne satisfy kele tar apan sangnar ki customer having good quality. First is the intrinsic product quality, and second is the customer satisfaction. The next other levels are mean time to failure. So that software will be rarely fail. Next is the defect density. So in that software, there will be, we can't say no defects, but very less defects. Then it solves all the customer problems. What are the needs of the customers that will be solved by that software? And customer satisfaction. Customer must be satisfied with the software. Then we call that this is the good quality software and it achieves product quality metrics. So already I have explained what is mean time to failure. Again, we will see in detail. So what is mean time to failure? It is the time between failures. So when your software fails, how much time you require for maintenance? And again, working of that particular software. It is called as mean time to failure. So that time must be very less. Then only we can conclude that this software is very good and mean time to failure is very less. So this metric is used with safety critical systems such as airline traffic control system and weapons. जेव्हा तुम्ही क्रिटिकल प्रोजेक्ट हँडल करता, एअरलाईन ट्राफिक कंट्रोल असेल किंवा वेपन्स, देन इफ मीन टाइम टू फेल्युअर इज ग्रेटर देन देर आर हाय चान्सेस ऑफ गेटिंग ऍक्सिडेंट्स. गेटिंग यू कांट टेल द पायलट दॅट व्हॉट इज द पोझिशन ऑफ युअर एरोप्लेन, देन हाऊ दॅट पर्सन कॅन कंट्रोल द प्लेन. So in this software, there must be a very less time, mean time to failure. If that software fails for milliseconds, that's okay. Getting? So this is mean time to failure. तुमचं जेव्हा software fail होईल तेव्हा कमीत कमी time मध्ये ते लगेच restart झालं पाहिजे. Next, defect density. What is the defects density? So it is measured the defects relative to software size. Ki tumcha software cha code ha kiti lines cha ahe and how many defects it is having. So using that we calculate the defect density. Next, customer problems. So in this we measure the problems that customer face when customer use software. Yes, so customer are not techno savvy, they don't have knowledge of technology, so you have to give the software such that anyone can easily access. Your graphical user interface must be user friendly so that everyone can get what is the menu, which are the options you are having. But if customer face some problems, then you have to give training to the customer and you have to upgrade the software as per the requirement of that customer and solve the problem. So in problem matrix we can call it as a PUM. So what is PUM? Problems per user month. How many problems that customer face in each month. So we are calculating that problems matrix and that problem matrix must be very low. Then next, what is PUM? There is formula What is the formula? Total problem that customer reported. In that problem, there are two types: true defects, non-defect oriented problems, plus total number of license months of software during the period. Then how it is calculated, number of license month. Also there is formula, number of installed license of the software, multiply the number of months in the calculation period. So like this way, we calculate the PUM problems. Yes. Problems per user month, PUM. And this term is calculated. Then next and last level is the customer satisfaction. So this is the 5-point scale. How you can measure the customer satisfaction? First is customer is very satisfied with the product, with the software. Second is the satisfied, it's okay. Third is the neutral. Then fourth is the disappointed. Customer is not satisfied. And last is the very disappointed. Customer does not like software or product at all. So these are the 5-point scale in customer satisfaction. So this you have to measure when you develop any product and given to the customer, this level you have to identify. Then for quality of software, there is a tool. That tool name is Ishikawa's 7 basic tools. So this is paper setter favorite question. Explain Ishikawa's 7 basic tools. So you have to explain what is Ishikawa's tools first. So what is this Ishikawa's 7 basic tool? It is a set of graphical techniques to identify troubleshooting issues in the software. Yes. So what is this Ishikawa's tools? Ki te graphical tools ahet. की त्याने तुमच्या सॉफ्टवेअरमध्ये काय काय प्रॉब्लेम्स आलेत आणि तुम्ही काय काय ट्रबल शूटिंग केलंय इन टर्म्स ऑफ क्वालिटी दॅट यू कॅन शो. सो फॉर दिस यू हॅव टू गिव लिटल ट्रेनिंग टू द पीपल. सो व्हॉट इज दिस? सो दीज आर द 7 बेसिक टूल्स. फर्स्ट इज द check sheet or checklist. Second is the histogram. Third is the Pareto chart. Then fourth is the control chart. Then fifth is the scatter diagram. Sixth is the satisfaction. And last is the cause and effect diagram. It is also called as fishbone or Ishikawa diagram. So the name is given by the developer. Karu Ishikawa has developed this technique, so that's why name is given as Ishikawa's. And there are 7 tools, so 7 basic tools. So in exam you have to explain each and every tool in detail. So what is checklist or check sheet? So you already know what is checklist or check sheet. This is the very basic tool for checking the quality of the software. So in checklist, you check the gathering and organizing of that data. So for that, you use any software like Microsoft Excel. And in that, you can use some tools like analysis graph or macros. Ada check sheet madhe kay kay asta nemka? In that check sheet, different types like defect location, then tally and defect cause check sheet. Yes. So what is the exact location of defects and how you are dealing with that? So this is about the check sheet. What is check sheet? Check sheet तुम्ही तुमच्या page वर पण तयार करू शकता. For example, when you go for trip or industry visit, you make a check sheet that all the items we have taken or not. So like that for software also, we can create a check sheet so that we can check that all the components are with us and which are the defects we have faced and have we handled that in terms of testing, that we can check. So for that we can use Microsoft Excel. So in Excel we can easily do calculation. Also we can easily plot the graphs. So this is the first tool. So check sheet or checklist used for checking the quality. So this is the check sheet. Sample check sheet they have given, and in that they have calculated for weekly basis, they have calculated the defects. In supplied part, how many defects have observed in each day. Using lines, they have calculated and they have written the weekly total. So they have given different defects in misaligning, in improved test procedure, in wrong part issued. So like that, there are different defects are there, and weekly they have written the count and finally the total. So like this way, we can create a check sheet, and that we can use Microsoft Excel to create this checklist or check sheet. Then next, histogram. So using histogram, we can display two variables in a histogram. So it is like a chart, in that we can use columns to display, and it represent the mean of distribution. And if that histogram is okay, then it shows the bell curve. But it is not okay, then it shows different shapes based on the condition. And for histogram, you always give two variables as input, one on x-axis and another on y-axis. Generally on x-axis there is time. So see, this is the histogram. Here in histogram they have displayed the number of attendees and this is the time. So we can easily visualize how many attendees. So like this way, we can use histograms for checking the quality of the software, that how many defects has occurred in that. Using that, using histogram, we can display that. Then next, Pareto chart. So what is Pareto chart? It is again a bar graph. It is used to arrange the information in such a way that priorities for proper process in improvement can be established. So Pareto diagram is like a bar graph. All of you know bar graph. So like histogram, it is that, and name is given Pareto due to the developer Wilfredo Pareto has developed, that he is the Italian economist and sociologist, developed these techniques. That's why name is given as Pareto charts. And what was the use of these? To improve the quality. So using Pareto charts, we can check what is the problem in our product, software product, and then we work on that problems, work on that issues, and then we with and the Pareto chart. So we can see Pareto chart. This is the structure of Pareto chart. Then fourth tool is control charts. So control chart is the best tool for monitoring the performance of the process in software product. So what you can control using control charts? That stability of process, prediction of that process, identification of common issues. So like this conditions you can monitor with the control charts. So this is the fourth Ishikawa tool. So this is your control chart. So like this we can check. And we can monitor the different processes. Then next, scatter diagram. So scatter diagram used to identify the existence of relationship between two pairs, like there are two atoms, then using that two atoms we can plot a graph, and that graph is in scattered way. That's why that graph is known as scatter diagram. So again, there are x-axis and y-axis. So like this, this is the scatter diagram. And what is scattered component? And what is the degree of correlations that is given? When that relationship is equally distributed, then we can conclude that this degree is of type none. If that degree is low, then that scatter diagram is like this second type. And degree is high, then all the points are making the traffic in the scatter diagram. So like these are the four types of scatter diagram, depend on the degree of correlation. Then next, flow charts. Already you are familiar with the flow charts. Yes. In second year, when you learn programming, for each program you have written algorithm and flow chart. So no need to again explain what is flow chart. That is the step by step execution of the program. So in software testing, you write which are the defects you find when you test that software and how you have handled that defects and given the improved version. So like this, this is the example of flowchart. First, in this is the software is developed for some hardware. So what are the problems they have faced? First is the lamp does not work. Then when that does not work, we have to check that lamp is plug-in or not. Then that pin is plug-in. Then we have to check that it is, there is problem in bulb or not. Otherwise, you have to replace that bulb. So like this way, you can develop flowchart for the software and we can maintain the quality. Then last, cause and effect diagram. So cause and effect diagram is used for understanding the business problems. What are the business problems are there, which are the causes, and the cause mul kay effect hoto tya business var. So how that cause and effect problems, so that we will see in next lecture. So type your names in chat for attendance.